Good morning, dear children. Today we are going to see the remaining part of the chapter number 2, Health and Diseases. So let us see, children, what is meant by infectious diseases. Diseases spread through contaminated air, water, food or vectors. Vectors such as insects or other animals are called as infectious diseases. Contaminated air, water and food means that is polluted air, water, and that food is not good for health. From that we are getting diseases. Such types of disease is called as infectious diseases. Children, in the textbook one chart is given regarding disease name, then from which bacteria or virus that disease can get, then mode of infection of that disease, symptoms, prevention and treatment. All these things are given for some diseases such as tuberculosis, hepatitis, dysentery, cholera and typhoid. But we will take more information about the diseases one by one. So first disease is tuberculosis. So this tuberculosis disease can get through the pathogen, that is bacteria, Mycobacterium tuberculi. So this tuberculi bacteria can get through contaminated air, water, food or sometimes other vectors also. And due to that, that person can get this disease. Tuberculosis or this TB is a contagious infection that usually attacks your lungs. Means the person who has getting this tuberculosis disease, on that person's lungs this disease can or this bacteria can attack. It can also spread to other parts of your body like your brain and spine also. So this disease can spread to other parts of body such as brain and spine, but specially it is or usually it attacks on lungs. Now let us see mode of infection for this tuberculosis. Spitting by patient, then through air, prolonged contact with and sharing of materials of patient. So obviously this is an infectious disease. So this disease can get by patient spitting, then with the help of air or prolonged contact, or we are coming in contact with that patient again and again or many times, in that time also that disease can spread. So let us see what is the meaning of sputum. Sputum is a liquid substance that is produced from the lower respiratory tract when one coughs. Okay, so sputum is a liquid substance, children, and that is produced in our lower respiratory tract when we are coughing. Okay, or any patient is coughing. In addition to mucus, sputum contains many materials that are not visible to the naked eye. It often consists of bacteria, cellular fragments, blood and pus. Okay, so in addition to this mucus, there are some materials, okay, in the sputum, but that is not visible to our naked eye, such as bacteria, sometimes cellular fragments, blood and pus also. So pus is what, children? That is a yellowish or greenish opaque liquid, and that is produced in infected tissue, in infected person's body. Okay. Now through sputum, how there is a spreading of this tuberculosis disease, that we will see, children, with the help of this picture. This same picture is given in the textbook also. So infection through sputum. So when any person is coughing, means those who are having this TB disease, and that person is spitting or coughing, that time there is a formation of some small droplets as well as some large droplets also. Okay, so what happens, there are some small droplets are given in the first, and that is vaporized into fine mist. So these small droplets are vaporized. Okay, so there is a formation of from this small droplets, there is a formation of vapors, and they are going in the fine mist. Mist means fog. Okay, they are spreading or they are gathered in the fog. Okay, so mist remains in the air for several hours to few hours, and this mist or fog in the air may sometimes in minutes also or sometimes in hours also. Okay, then large droplets, whichever large droplets are coming from that coughing, so these large droplets settle on the ground within few seconds. And these large droplets are settling on the ground within few seconds. So with the help of these small droplets as well as from large droplets also, the patient's sputum can spread. Means the patient's disease can spread from one person to another person, because we know children in the air, if that is remain for minutes or sometimes for seconds also, few hours also, then if any person is coming in contact with that air, then obviously that person can get this TB disease from air also. Okay, I hope children you all have understood this diagram. Now there are some reasons also, from that reason also this TB can spread. So this TB spread from person to person by airborne transmission, means with the help of air only. Sometimes when we are talking with that TB patient, then coughing, sneezing and laughing, means any TB patient is coughing, sneezing or he is laughing or he is talking, then that time also that disease can spread from one person to another person. Now let us see children symptoms for this tuberculosis, that is TB. Chronic cough. Chronic means that cough is coming from many days or many weeks, such as a cough that lasts for, or that is remain for 8 weeks or more than 8 weeks, that cough is called as chronic cough. Then bloody spitting. Okay, so when that person is spitting, then from that spitting there is a formation of some blood drops. Okay, and that is called as bloody spitting. Then emaciation. Emaciation means the person becomes thin and weak. Usually it becomes due to illness or extreme hunger. Means that person has feeling that hungriness. Okay, and then due to illness, okay, that person becomes day by day thin and weak. That is the main symptom of this tuberculosis, that is emaciation. Now difficulty in breathing, and due to coughing, chronic cough is there, in so long time that cough is remain, and due to that sometimes there is a difficulty in breathing also. So these are all the main symptoms of tuberculosis. Now let us see children prevention and treatment for tuberculosis. So to prevent tuberculosis, we have to take BCG vaccine. BCG vaccine means bacillus calmette guerin vaccine. This vaccine is primarily using against this tuberculosis. So this vaccine is given to small baby after his or her birth. Okay, as soon as possible, these doctors are giving in the first week only this BCG vaccine. Now second prevention is isolation of patient. So that patient should be isolated from the other persons, means the person who have or are suspected to having infectious of TB disease, means that person has looking the symptoms of TB, then that person should be away from the other patients or away from the other persons. Okay, and that room is called as isolation room. That person should not come in contact with other persons. Okay, so isolation of patient is needed for this tuberculosis prevention. Now next is regular medication like DOT. Okay, so DOT is the directly observed treatment. Okay, means that is a short course for this TB, that is tuberculosis. So in this DOT test, what happens children? The control strategy recommended by World Health Organization. So this DOT therapy is from the World Health Organization, means directly observed treatment is there. So in that treatment, what happens children? So So the sputum test is done through microscopy. So whichever sample is there from that sample, that is sputum sample is taken from that TB patient, and that can be tested in the microscope. Okay. Then medicines are given under the observation of health service provider, and according to that, doctors are giving some medicines to that patient, and this treatment is completely free. Okay, so they are not taking any charges for this tuberculosis. Then for this giving medicine or the test, doctors are keeping complete record of the patient, okay, till the patient's treatment is going on. And such type of therapy is called as, children, that is directly observed treatment. Now second disease is, that is hepatitis or jaundice. So this hepatitis disease can get through pathogen, that is virus, hepatitis virus A, B, C, D and E. Okay. So hepatitis means inflammation of the liver, means that hepatitis virus can attack on our liver. The liver is vital organ that process nutrients, filter the blood and fights infection. Okay. So that is the important organ. Liver is the important organ because that is processing nutrients also, then filtering blood also, and it fights on our infections also. Means any infection we are getting from any media, then it can fight on the infection also. Then when the liver is damaged, then what happens? Function can be affected. So its function will not be regular or normal. If liver has damage or it gets any infection. Now inflammation means what, children? A localized reaction that produces redness, warm, swelling and pain as a result of infection. Okay. So due to something reaction, there is a redness or swelling is coming, or sometimes temperature is also becoming high. Okay. Or there is a pain in that infection part, infected part, or irritation is there, or injury is there. Such type of infections are called as inflammation. And this inflammation can be sometimes external or sometimes internal also. I hope, children, it is clear to you. Now, mode of infection for this hepatitis. So, this hepatitis can get through contaminated water, sharing of needles and blood transfusion. So sometimes doctors are not checking the blood before transferring to other person. Okay, so that infected blood from that patient's body, that blood is transferring to other person, then also this disease can get, that is hepatitis. And this contaminated needles and syringe like that from that hepatitis patient, that is used by doctor to other person, then also this hepatitis can spread. Now mother to baby, suppose mother has this hepatitis disease, then obviously that disease can get to their babies also. Okay, so there are some mode of infection for this disease. Again, if infected hepatitis patients, organ and tissue transplantation is to other persons, then also this disease can spread. Then sexual transmission. Okay, so no proper sexual contact is there partner, then also this disease can spread. So these are the some mode of infection, but main mode of infections are contaminated water, sharing of needles and blood transfusion. Now symptoms for this hepatitis: anorexia. Anorexia is a eating disorder. Okay, so in this disorder, that person is not eating, okay, for losing his body weight, but that person has fear that he can gain his body weight, or he can increase his body weight, and due to that person is not eating properly for losing body weight. Okay, and such type of disorder is called as anorexia. Then instead of this, symptoms of hepatitis are yellow urine, general weakness, nausea, means before omitting that type of sensation is there, okay, or that type of symptoms are there, that is called as nausea, then omitting and gray stool. These are the main symptoms of this hepatitis. Now, prevention and treatment for this hepatitis. So the person who has hepatitis, so that person has to drink boiled water only. Then proper cleaning of hands are also essential for this prevention and treatment of hepatitis. Okay. Then maintain good hygiene. That is also one of the prevention for this hepatitis or jaundice. Now proper vaccination against hepatitis A and B. Okay. Then avoid to take alcohol. Then ensure safe injection practices. Then avoid contaminated food and water. That is also main prevention or main precaution for this hepatitis or jaundice. I hope children it is clear to you now. Now next disease is dysentery. So this dysentery can get through pathogen, that is bacteria, virus, shigella, bacilli, entamoeba, histolytica. So these are the main virus or bacteria for the dysentery. So mode of infection for the hepatitis, that is contaminated food and water. If contaminated food and water is going in our body, then there are chances to get this hepatitis. See in the picture, children, you can understand from that feces how that feces is going in the vegetation. Okay, then how this feces is going through or transferred through flies, then from hands and from water, and how that food and water is becoming contaminated, and if that food or water is eaten by any person, then how that disease can spread. So there are main mode of infection, that is contaminated food and water. So there are some symptoms for this hepatitis, that is watery stool. Okay, then pains in the abdomen. So the person who has hepatitis, that person can get pains in the abdomen. So these are the main symptoms of hepatitis. Now prevention and treatment for hepatitis: drinking of boiled water, then proper storage of food, means food should be properly stored, then ORS consumption. These are the main prevention and treatment against hepatitis. So ORS consumption is what, children? That is oral rehydration salt is there, and that salt can be mixed in the boiled water. Means after boiling, that can be cooled, and in that salt, okay, this ORS consumption can be mixed, and after cooling that water can be given to the patient. That is called as ORS consumption. Now next disease is, children, cholera. So pathogen for this cholera disease is Vibrio cholerae. That is one of the bacteria, and from that bacteria there are chances to get this cholera disease. Now mode of infection for this cholera, that is contaminated food and water. So if persons are not using latrine properly, okay, and they are doing this feces, and they are doing on this whichever work is there on the open place only, then from that also there are chances to get this cholera disease. That is with the help of flies, then not washing hands properly, then from that hand also, sometimes from the food also, there are chances to get this disease. And sometimes this feces are going in the drinking water also, okay, and due to that, if it can be eat, means this water can be drink or that food can be eat by any person, then that person can get this disease, that is cholera. Now symptoms of this cholera, that is vomiting, severe diarrhea, the cramps in the legs. Instead of this, there are some main symptoms also: the blood pressure of that person becomes low, okay, then loss of skin elasticity, means due to loss of water the skin is becoming very loose, okay, means that skin loses its elasticity. Then increased thirst, okay, due to loss of water through diarrhea, okay, then they are omitting that person has getting very thirsty, okay, or that person is drinking water again and again. So these are the main symptoms of this cholera disease. Now, prevention and treatment of cholera. So follow hygienic practices, means wash your hands often with soap and water. Then avoid open place food, so not to eat anything from the outside. Then drinking boiled water, we should drink boiled water only, and we have to take vaccination against the cholera. So these are the main prevention for this cholera disease. Now children, next disease is typhoid. So this typhoid can get through the bacteria, that is Salmonella typhi. Now mode of infection for this disease, typhoid, that is contaminated food and water, and sometimes there is using toilet, contaminated toilet with bacteria, not washing hands properly. Due to that also that disease can spread. Now symptoms are there. Which are the symptoms for this typhoid? That is anorexia. Anorexia is already I explained to children, that is eating disorder disease is there. In that disorder, person is keeping star or not eating anything for the fear that he can increase his body weight. And due to that, for losing body weight, that person is not eating anything. That is called as anorexia. Then headache, rash on abdomen, dysentery, and fever is going up to 104 degree Fahrenheit. So these are the main symptoms of this typhoid disease. Now what is the prevention and treatment for typhoid? So drink boiled water, vaccination against typhoid, and proper disposal of sewage. Sewage water means whichever water is going, open canals are there, open chambers are there near to our houses, and this chamber water they are sending directly in the canal or directly in the river. Then also that river water or canal water will become dirty, and if that can be mixed in the drinking water, then there are chances to get typhoid. So due to that, proper disposal of sewage water is important. Now there are some infectious diseases also children, that is enteritis, malaria, plague and AIDS. So we have to take more information about these diseases. So enteritis, this disease can get through pathogen, that is infectious bacteria, virus, worms, ingestion of harmful chemical substances. Okay, so these are the pathogens responsible for this disease, that is enteritis. Now mode of infection for this, contaminated food, water or other drinks also. Symptoms are there, stomachache, fever, vomiting, anorexia, that is not to eat anything by fear that that person can increase his body weight, that is called as anorexia. Then loss of body weight, loose motion, these are the symptoms for this enteritis. Then prevention and treatment. So proper medicine, ORS consumption, that is oral rehydration syrup, can that patient can take. Then light diet, safe food, personal hygiene, and then proper storage of food. These are the prevention and treatment for this enteritis disease. Now next is malaria. This malaria can get through this protozoa, that is Plasmodium vivax. Okay, that is the pathogen. Now mode of infection, through the bite of female Anopheles mosquito, and that mosquito is a vector. Vector means from that mosquito only that disease can spread. Now symptoms, headache and fever with chills. Okay, fever is coming with chill, that is the main symptoms for this malaria. Then prevention is proper medicine under the guidance of doctor or physician. This is the main prevention and treatment for this malaria. Now plague. Plague can get through bacteria, that is Yersinia pestis. Then mode of infection, through bite of flea, which are carriers of this bacteria. So the flea is, that is insect is biting the person, and through if that flea is carrier of this bacteria, then maybe there are chances to get this disease from one person to another person. Now next is, there are symptoms. There are three types of plague, and each with different symptoms, and that is having different symptoms. Okay. Then prevention and treatment. So treatment with appropriate antibiotic. So for this prevention of plague, that person has to take proper or appropriate antibiotic prescribed by the doctor. Okay. Now next disease is AIDS. This AIDS disease can get through virus, that is HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. Okay. Then mode of infection, through sexual contact, blood contamination and needles. So these are the main mode of infection for this AIDS. Now symptoms, weakening of immunity, means that person is becoming very weak day by day, weight loss, fever or night sweat, means that person has getting fever and sometimes night sweat also, means at the time of night only much more sweat is coming. So these are the main symptoms of this AIDS. Then prevention and treatment for AIDS is antiretroviral therapy. Antiretroviral therapy, or that is also called as ART therapy, is useful for this prevention of AIDS. And then HIV medication, that is from doctor. So these are the best prevention and treatment for this AIDS. Now next, that is observe and discuss. One picture is given in the textbook also, children. Observe, you have to observe that picture and you have to discuss. So where do you see in the picture, that is waterlogged materials? So in the picture we can see, children, in case of drum, bucket, flower pot and that vehicle tire also, we can see some water is locked in that, in these materials. Now which hazards do you anticipate with the help of picture? So we can get anticipate, or we can anticipate with the help of this picture, we can understand. So there is a spreading of mosquito from this dirty or polluted water. Okay, so wherever dirty water is there or polluted water is stored or locked in that material, these mosquitoes are breeding in the dirty and polluted water, and due to that we have to remove these things as early as possible. Because what happens if there is a dirty water or stored water is there? So in that obviously mosquitoes will come and they will lay eggs, and from these eggs there is a formation of more mosquitoes, and due to that there is a spreading of diseases through mosquitoes. Thank you, children, for watching the video and for your attention.